अस्सलाम वालेकुम व्यूअर्स, मैं हूं आपका होस्ट अमजद इस्लाम अमजद और आप देख रहे हैं यूट्यूब चैनल एकेडमिक हब। अगर आप इस चैनल पर नए हैं और आपने अभी तक इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया तो इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन प्रेस करें ताकि हमारी लेटेस्ट वीडियोस बिला ताखीर आपको मिलती रहें। व्यूअर्स, एज यू नो आई हैव स्टार्टेड सीरीज ऑफ लेक्चर्स on your syllabus for PPSC and FPSC jobs. So all of you are welcome in my first lecture on curriculum development. Curriculum development is very important subject as far as your PPSC and FPSC jobs are concerned. And my these lectures will help all of you in attempting written tests and interviews of your PPSC and FPSC jobs. So, to clear your written tests and interviews, stay tuned to my YouTube channel, Academic Hub. Content of my today's lecture will be concept and meaning of curriculum, definitions of curriculum, characteristics of curriculum, components of curriculum, need of curriculum, and in the end, there will be few simple multiple choice questions which will help all of you to assess your learning after this lecture. Let's move forward. Here we will see concept and meaning of curriculum. Curriculum has its root in Latin language and it is derived from the word correre, which means to run, which later come to stand as the course of study. There was a time when curriculum was understood as a pathway by traveling on which educational objectives can be achieved. But with passage of time, the very concept and definition of curriculum also changed. And now, curriculum is considered as total of all learning content, experience, and resources that one purposely selected, organized, and implement by school in order to achieve educational objectives. So, from this slide, we made our three concepts. Number one, that curriculum has roots in Latin language. Second one, that it is derived from the word correre, which means to run. And third one is that it's total of all learning content and experiences organized and implemented by schools. Let's move to our next slide, which has two definitions of curriculum. Alberti defined curriculum as the sum total of student activities which the school sponsors for the purpose of achieving its objectives. I have taken next definition from Blount's Encyclopedia, which is very famous encyclopedia of education, and it defines curriculum as all the experience a pupil has under the guidance of the school. From this definition, we can also make an understanding that curriculum is the total sum of all experiences which a pupil had in school. Now let's move towards our next slide, which is about characteristics of curriculum. Here we will see what sort of characteristics a curriculum should have. Number one is totality of activities. By curriculum, it is meant all the school activities which are used to promote the development of the pupils. It refers to the totality of subject matter, activities, and experiences which constitutes a pupil's school life. The next characteristic which curriculum should have is a means to an end. It is known that curriculum is not an end in itself, but a means to an end. Therefore, it is created so as to achieve the aims of education. That is the reason why different educationists have suggested different kinds of curricula to conform to the aims and objectives ascribed to education. It follows that the curriculum will change with every change in the aims of education.
नेक्स्ट करेक्टरिस्टिक आई विल टॉक ऑन इज टोटल स्कूल एनवायरनमेंट। एज यू नो द टोटल एनवायरनमेंट ऑफ स्कूल इन्फ्लुएंसेस करिकुलम। इट इज मेड अप ऑफ एवरीथिंग दैट सराउंड्स द लर्नर इन ऑल हिज वर्किंग आवर्स। वी कैन से इट इज द एनवायरनमेंट इन मोशन। इट रेफर्स टू टोटल एजुकेशनल प्रोग्राम ऑफ स्कूल इंक्लूडिंग ऑल एक्सपीरियंसेस एक्टिविटीज and learning in which the learner is expected to progress and attain the goals of education. Our fourth characteristic is totality of experience. Curriculum refers to the totality of experience that a pupil gets in the school. During school hours, students have different experiences in classroom, library, laboratory, workshops, playgrounds and in the numerous informal contacts between the teacher and the pupils. These experiences can be inside or outside of the school. And all these experiences help students in the development of their personality. As you know, curriculum includes not merely syllabus and books, but all those experiences and relationships which help him to develop as an individual. So, a good curriculum should have the characteristic of totality of experience. Next characteristic of curriculum, which I will discuss here, is mirror of curricular and co-curricular trends. Viewers, curriculum forms the mirror of curricular and co-curricular trends and is able to reflect the curricular and co-curricular trends in our educational institutions. It can depict the aims and objectives of education, the methodology of teaching, including teaching aids and evaluation techniques. So, we can conclude that curriculum plays a role of mirror, which shows us what sort of curricular and co-curricular trends a school, a community has. And same sort of things you can discuss in our next point, curriculum as mirror of educational trends. Because curriculum depicts the picture about the prevailing educational system. Views the objectives behind the educational system are highlighted through the series of experiences which are provided by the curriculum. Let's move towards our next slide. First characteristic on this slide is development of balanced personality. Viewers, curriculum is quite helpful in the development of a balanced personality. The activities in curriculum concerning physical, intellectual, emotional, social, economic, aesthetic, and cultural development play their role for developing a balanced personality. Viewers, curriculum is the process of living in which interactions between the individuals and his environment takes place. Curriculum is concerned both with the life of the individual and his environment. So, it has the aspect of process of living. Our next point is that curriculum is dynamic because the needs and interests of pupil going on changing with passage of time. So, for these varying needs, different types of activities are required and this tends to necessitate some changes in curriculum. Curriculum is never static. It has to be different for different students, different classes and different schools. It has to be kept dynamic in order to keep with the needs, interests, abilities, attitude and lives of the pupils. And besides that, curriculum has the characteristics to mirror philosophy of life. It depicts philosophy of life. Either it is democratic or autocratic. Each way of life is having different philosophy and hence different goals of education. Our last point is achievement of goals. So viewers, curriculum is prepared to achieve some set goals and objectives of education, which are set by society. So, curriculum helps in achieving the aims and objectives of education. On my next slide, I will discuss about components of curriculum. Viewers, you should keep in mind that every curriculum has three components. You have to memorize, you have to cram that there are only three components of curriculum. The first one is program of studies, and this refers to the various subjects like history, language, mathematics, and our social and natural sciences, which we had at our elementary and secondary levels of education. In every class and grade, 6-7 different subjects are taught, and it is all about program of studies. Next component is program of activities. In view of the importance in the promotion of ideas of citizenship, cooperative living, and democracy, therefore, many educators advocate that curriculum should be envisaged in terms of only activities rather than the subjects taught in school. Our last component is program of guidance. A comprehensive program of guidance includes helping students to solve their educational, vocational, and personal problems. So, these were the three components of curriculum. Let's move towards next slide, which is about the need of curriculum. Here, I will tell that why a school, a community, or a country needs curriculum. The first point is achievement of educational aims. So, viewers, it's only curriculum which render helps in achieving the aims of education. And without suitable curriculum, aims of education cannot be achieved. My next point is fixing limits for teachers and students. Very self-explanatory, because it's just curriculum which determines the work of teacher as well as that of student. My next point is development of democratic values. As all of you are aware that it's curriculum which is helpful to the students in developing democratic values such as liberty, equality, fraternity, justice, respect for dignity of individuals and of group livings. Next point is development of citizenship. Again, very self-explanatory. It's curriculum which helps us to develop the sense of citizen among individuals. My next point is development of character. There is no system of education which does not aim at developing character in the youth. So, character can be developed with help of a suitable curriculum. Our next point is satisfaction of needs. There is a great variety of interests, skill, abilities, attitudes, aptitudes, and requirements of students. And it is just curriculum which satisfies students' educational, vocational, and psychological needs. My next point is criteria for suitable teachers. Viewers, curriculum mainly shows what type of teacher is needed in school. We should know what type of work they are required to do, and this is to be in accordance with the requirements of curriculum. Next point is selection of suitable methods. Viewers, it's just curriculum which will determine how to teach and what to teach, when to teach and where to teach. My next point is acquisition of knowledge, which is most simplest among these points because it's primary function of curriculum to help students in getting knowledge. By studying various subjects laid down in the curriculum, the students gets knowledge in conformity with the abilities and level of intelligence. Sometimes we define education as preparation of life and preparation of personality. So my next point is development of personality. Viewers, curriculum is helpful in developing physical, intellectual, aesthetics, social, cultural, moral, spiritual, religious, and vocational abilities of students. So, suitable curriculum is necessary for the complete and balanced development of personality. My last point, again self-explanatory, reflects trends in education. So, curriculum of any state or country reflects the trends in education and changes in the philosophy of that state or country. Viewers, this was all about from me on this topic. Now let's move towards our sample MCQs. First question is, the term curriculum is derived from which language? Greek, Latin, English or Hindi? You have to decide, you have to choose and pick one option. Next statement is, the word courier means to look after, to run, to teach, to bring up. Choose and pick one correct option for this statement. Next statement is, components of curriculum are 5, 7, 3, 4. So you have to choose one right option from here. My last question is, development of balanced personality, dynamic and process of living are dash 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 of curriculum. You have options of elements, components, characteristics and need. From all these options, you have to pick one right option for every statement and to comment it in comment box of this video. I will evaluate and will tell you correct options there. Viewers, if you like this video, like it, comment it and share it with your friends, colleagues and students. Stay always happy and blessed. So till my next video, Allah Hafiz.